I'm going to show you three different options you can use to clone your own produce and or herbs. And welcome back to More Approved. I'm James, and this is a continuation of my gardening series. We're going to do a couple of videos on this every so often, and I just so happen to be on a kick for getting things done and accomplished in my garden. And today we're making a DIY cloning bucket. It's down and dirty, it's easy and fairly cheap to make. So the basic things that you're going to need for this build, obviously you will need a bucket that has a lid. You're also going to need a hole saw, you're going to need some net pots, net cups, whatever these things are, and you're also going to need some cloning collars. Beyond that, you are going to need some 180 degree sprinkler heads, Mr. Heads, whatever you want to call them, micro sprayers, a zip tie, some flexible tubing, and a pump adapter that will fit in your flexible tubing. First step, you're going to want to take and pre-drill all of your holes. Once your holes are all cut out, we can go ahead and move on to the next step. So we'll go ahead and set this stuff aside. This portion is focusing on the pump and the feed line for all of your little sprayer heads. I think we're gonna cut it right here. And actually, because we have to crimp it off, we're gonna cut it right here. Now you can buy little plugs that go onto the inside of this, but I prefer the crimping method. So you just go ahead, fold a section of it over. And then we're gonna use a zip tie. So now we're just gonna go ahead, put this tube back into the pump. So this pump will sit in this bucket, and then this tube is gonna look a lot like that. So we're gonna take and put a sprayer here, one in the center, and maybe one on the bottom even, right in here. Now we're just gonna take our little reamer. Now we're gonna take four of our micro spray heads, which is this guy. Now for the final one, it's just on the bottom here. Now it's time to see if this thing's going to work. And we're better than my kitchen sink. Three, two, one. It's good. It is now day two, and I'm going to show you the second way that you can make yourself a cloning setup. We're going to use the same bucket, we're going to use the same lid, and we're going to use these same pieces. All right, so we have the lid set out of the way, but we're going to go ahead and reach in here. This is a very effective means of cloning. There are two different variations. I am showing you the second way right now. I just couldn't find all the parts last night. I was hoping to actually finish this film last night, but it was late and I was tired, so I did not finish it. So my apologies. So anyways, with the first variation, I had to add in a couple of more sprayers. This does work. You want to make sure that when you take out your net pots to really test to see if this is working, some water should be shooting out of those holes. And the more water that you have hitting the base pieces of your clippings, the more root production that you're going to have. So this is a very effective cloning method. Whew.
That was weird. See,
it is a very effective cloning method.
Right.
So while he pulls that
out of there,
I'll try to be quiet.
I'll take this apart for you
and show you the secondary method, which I typically use in my cloning buckets. I just had to find a couple of pieces. So you're just going to need a threaded riser, a small section of pipe, and two end caps. And you shouldn't have to glue any of this up. So I'm just going to cut this guy right in half. Then I'm going to insert into here, insert into here, and then I'm going to push on my caps. So let me go grab my drill, and then we'll get everything into place and then pick up where we left off. Can you please move out of my way?
Get out of here.
Thank you. Yeah. So we're just going to take and drill our holes. And you just have to take and set them into place. Give them a quick twist. And I'm going to adjust these to be at different angles. So I'm going to have one spraying this way. I'm going to have one spraying this way. And then these two guys are going to be at opposite angles. Then all you have to do is take this, screw it into place. Moment of truth. We have water spraying out of the tops. Now, another thing that you may want to look into if you are going to be cloning or doing any sort of aeroponics, you're going to want yourself a nice timer. You can go with the El Cheapo, and this is 30 minutes on, 30 minutes off. That will work for cloning. This is the Apollo 8. This is 15 minutes on, 15 minutes off. And if you want to take it to the next step, this is the Titan Apollo 12. I really, really, really like this. You can have 5 seconds to 30 minutes on your on time, and you can have 5 seconds to 60 minutes on your off time. We are going to discuss one more method for cloning, which you don't need any of this for. It is simple. So the last method, which you need none of this for, so if you don't want to spend any money, but you want to try to grow indoors, this is what you can do. Go outside, take a clipping off of your tomato plant or your pepper plant. Pepper plants take longer to grow, just for the record. And you want to cut this off at about a 45 degree angle. Chop off your lower leaves. In any larger leaves that you have, that's it. But when doing a cloning bucket and you have these little net cups, what you want to do actually is cut this off. These are just going to get in your way when you're trying to put the roots back in after you pull it out to look at them, or you're trying to remove the roots from this plastic piece before you plant. This just gets in the way. This is to hold like rock wool or some other growing media that will help your plant stay upright. So if you're doing the cloning bucket method, all you have to do, put that into my cloning collar. Make sure he's sort of upright. Boom, he's into place. And then I'm going to run this probably 1 minute on, 2 minutes off. And that's just because I have a really awesome timer to control this. So that wraps this up. If you do not want to do said cloning bucket, you now have a cloning jar. But thanks for watching, everyone. I will leave links down below for everything that you've seen here, including the awesome timer and the more affordable timers in case you want to do this method. And I will also leave a link for the pump that I use. That's a Eco 396. Gallons per hour sort of thing. Works really, really well. I actually have it a lot larger than what I need it in case I want to run Dutch bucket system, which I have in the past. I might show you some pictures of that eventually. But anyways, thanks for watching. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. If you like this, give me a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave some comments down below. And thanks so much for watching. I'm James. Till next time, see you then.